Finish tonight. Republicans are outraged over Chuck Hagel's nomination for defense secretary. Meanwhile, they have no problem with known conspiracy theorist Michelle Bachmann, congresswoman from Minnesota, retaining her seat on the House Intelligence Committee. Remember, it was Bachmann who led the witch hunt against Hillary Clinton's aide, Huma Abedin, last year. In a wild conspiracy theory, Bachmann claimed Abedin had ties to a Muslim extremist group. Bachmann's fear-mongering campaign against Muslims included absurd statements like this.
It appears that there has been deep penetration in the halls of our United States government by the Muslim Brotherhood. The Muslim Brotherhood has been found to be an unindicted co-conspirator on terrorism cases. And yet, it appears that there are individuals who are associated with the Muslim Brotherhood who have positions and very sensitive positions in our Department of Justice, our Department of Homeland Security, potentially even in the National Intelligence Agency.
Bachmann's Muslim witch hunt drew a wide range of criticism from both parties. Her former presidential campaign chief, Ed Rollins, slammed the baseless attack, saying, as a member of Congress with a seat on the House Intelligence Committee, Ms. Bachmann, you know better. Shame on you, Michelle. Now, John Boehner's decision to reappoint Bachmann to the House Intelligence Committee has Democrats furious. The liberal group, People for the American Way, released a statement today saying, members of the House Intelligence Committee are entrusted with classified information that affects the safety and security of all Americans. That information should not be in the hands of anyone with such a disregard for honesty, misunderstanding of national security, and lack of respect for his or her fellow public servants. The group currently has a petition to remove Bachmann from the Intel Committee. So far, it has over 80,000 signatures. And if you want to sign that petition, visit PFAW.org. For more, let's turn to Karen Finney, MSNBC political analyst and former communications director for the DNC. Karen, good to have you with us tonight. I find it interesting that Republicans are just absolutely outraged over Chuck Hagel questioning his qualifications and positions, but they have no problem with Michelle Bachmann on the Intel Committee after the stunt she pulled. Make any sense of it?
Well, you know, and here's the thing, Ed. It wasn't just a stunt, because remember that what she did with Huma at that time actually endangered her safety to the point that Huma had to have police protection. And remember, at that time, she had a new baby. So Michelle Bachmann has already shown a willingness to abuse information in a very reckless way and endanger the life of an American citizen and her child. I mean, I think we should be very clear about what this woman is all about. Now, with regard to Boehner, I think what it shows is how weak he really is after that vote last week, because he clearly is feeling that he's got to do these kinds of things to appease those sort of right-wing crazies in his caucus. There's no other reason for someone like this to be returned to the Intelligence Committee.
I mean, that was quite an indictment that Michelle Bachmann made of Hillary Clinton's aide.
Yep.
So how can she be trusted by any members of Congress to withhold information which could be very sensitive to our security? Why would they put Michelle Bachmann in a position like that after what she did?
Well, she can't be trusted, and she's already proven that she can't be trusted, and that's what, you know, the situation with Huma proved. I think, again, with regard to Speaker Boehner, it shows that he is weak and feels that he's got to appease the right wing. But also, you know what, Ed, this is an embarrassment to the United States of America, because remember that in other countries, when they see a person like a Michelle Bachmann, who is a part of the American government, they don't necessarily always make the distinction between the Congress and the administration and all that. They see someone who is an instrument of the American government on a witch hunt against Muslims. Now, how do you think that impacts the way people think and feel about this country and other parts of the world if that's the kind of person that's out there representing us on something called the Intelligence Committee?
Well, I just don't know how anybody could come to the conclusion that the country is a lot safer with Michelle Bachmann having access to intel information.
And that's right.
Will there be enough public support that could change this, that could remove her from the Intel Committee?
You know, probably not, because again, I think Boehner is so weakened, I don't think that he would have the courage to do something like that, because I think he can't risk angering the far right wing. There should be, Ed, because as you point out, again, this is a woman who's already proven she can't be trusted with sensitive information, that she has no problem using it for her own political purposes, and she has no problem just, you know, talking off the cuff and saying all kinds of crazy things.
We'll be right back. Are you a flake?
Well, I think that would be insulting to say something like that because I'm a serious person.
You understand when I say that's what the rap on you is.
Well, what I would say is that...
We give you Michelle Bachmann in her own words.
You are now looking at a fool for Christ.
I want people in Minnesota armed and dangerous.
I know enough not to fight with a dump truck.
Now we've moved into the realm of gangster government. We have gangster government.
This is the crown jewel of socialism. This is socialized medicine.
If we allow this to happen, group marriage, polygamy, and things much worse may not be far behind.
We have seen an orgy. The government spent its wad.
What is it that Barack Obama really believes? I'm very concerned that he may have anti-American views. It's great just to be able to get my message out. And if I get under people's skin, so be it.
The Congresswoman still seems to be working on those ideas, particularly when it comes to whether President Bachmann would sign Paul Ryan's Medicare plan into law. Now, she voted for that bill.
I appreciate the fact that my colleague Paul Ryan has been serious about looking at this issue. I put an asterisk on my support in that.
But do you recognize that now that you're in the spotlight in a way that you weren't before, that you have to be careful and not say what some regard as flaky things?
THillaryClinton.com.